So I've prepared the dress basically just by doing the side seams, attaching it on the shoulder. I've still not piped it around the neckline and done the hem, but apart from that, I'm gonna attach the sleeves now. The lining, I've attached it on the sides, but at the bottom I've left it separate, and I've turned that over as well. Turn it back inside out. You could do with probably overlocking it before you attach the sleeves on. Now, as we said, we were going to attach this on towards the front, so the one that we're going to do is this one first. Put the sleeve inside, it's going to be attached on the round. There is like a iron mark there, and that iron mark we're going to line it with the inside of the armhole. Position the needle and just attach around. Just lift the foot slightly where we need to. Now I've done the pleats on the top of the sleeve. I think these need reinforcing a little bit, so you can slightly push these in so that they're more compact, because the sleeve is actually not, just about fits right. I was thinking it was going to be, sleeve was going to be a bit too wide. If you feel that it's just coming out marginally tight, what you can do is take out, I thought I had to add this pleats, but I have to take one out. And you're just attaching this on the round. The other one as well, and then turn it over and see what we managed to achieve with this sleeve. So again, this way, this time you're going the back way, so just bear in mind that if you've unpicked a pleat, then you would need to do the same on this sleeve as well. Before we actually go and overlock this, make sure that the sleeves are sitting where you want them to sit. So that's where we opted to have the seam coming. Just a little bit wide the armhole, but for the type of sleeve we've got, we should get away with it. So I'm going to just finish this off now. I've just got to turn the sides, a little bit turning on the hem and press it, and that basically is then the dress completed. I'm going to go on to show you how to pleat the salwar. What we've done with the salwar is we're going to come back in step two, but what we've basically done is pre-prepared the lining side of this. So that's the bottom, and we're going to use the lining as our base to pleat the salwar. So that's the inside of the pajama. As you can see, it might just seem just a little bit long actually. You can always tuck it into the socks or you can always turn it over. Just to, I might just elasticate this actually so it stays up just a little bit higher than her other trouser. That's another way of cutting down the length. If you elasticate it, the elastic, you can just put it above on the ankles, and that will keep, you know, keep the bagged look as well, and also stop the salwar from dropping below the ankles.